Hey, everybody. Welcome to psychology. You're in a lot of ways, welcome back, because I haven't had you guys in class since American history. And, you know, I wish obviously we were sitting in the same room together doing this, but we're going to make the best of it. So, hey, it's Seep. You know, if you're watching this, that means you couldn't come to class today for some reason. And I appreciate that there's a lot of different things that come up during the course of the day. So I hope you're well. Just so you guys understand, what I'm going to do every day is I'm going to post a video like this in Classroom, and it's going to be called In Case You Miss Psychology, and then the name of the date. And it's going to basically run through whatever we did in class that day. Obviously, I'll probably be a little quicker version of things because it won't have that interaction, but it'll be a little bit cleaner version. It also makes sure that, you know, if you are in class, you're not getting recorded and things like that. So it's just easier to do it this way. So welcome to psychology. This is going to be a lot different than the last class you had with me. If you had American history with me, in American history, we covered a lot of facts and figures and dates and events and things. And in psychology, we don't do any of that. Well, that's a lie. We do talk a little bit about the history of psych for 10 minutes in the very, very first quarter here. But we're going to talk a lot about you and me and the people around you and what we do and why we do it and how works. So I hope that this is something that you're going to be interested in. I really think it's something that's very useful. And so here's a rundown on what we're going to do today. First of all, I'm going to give you guys a little bit of background on the class. We're going to go through the rules and policies and things like that, grading, all the fun stuff. And then we'll talk a little bit about how I got to this point being a psychology teacher, but also kind of, try to figure out some things about what we're going to talk about and those kind of things. And then I have an about you survey that I'd love you guys to fill out for me. So I'm going to stay like this instead of going into present mode because I just like to be able to, to see you guys like I can see you. But I think it makes more sense if you guys can see me as I'm talking about things. So what we're going to do today is we're going to do the first day stuff, but we're going to get going by looking at why are you here and the field of psychology. So for starters, this was my first quarter semester. I call them core masters. I had nothing but freshmen, 3 hours of American history. And while they were nice and they were sweet, they were freshmen, and doing things online was really interesting. Some days, two-thirds of them would have their cameras on, and some days nobody had their cameras on. And sometimes I asked questions and I'd sit for a minute and no one would say anything. And so I felt like this lady, I knew exactly what I was doing. I knew how it was supposed to work. But for some reason, some days I ate it, and I would say it ended pretty well. I really liked them. They're good kids. I think you guys would have fun with them if we could be around. But, hey, it is what it is. Now we got to get some of the first day stuff done. And so bear with me as I go through these things with you guys. Obviously, I shared this with you guys so you have the ability to go in and look at the doc that I'm about to go on to. I do want to make sure that you guys all do understand especially how you're going to be graded, because, in these condensed time windows, it doesn't give you a lot of chance to, make a lot of mistakes. Okay. So your kind of stuff for online psych, sorry, I was already looking at this and didn't pull it back. Obviously you're in psych one and you're getting half a credit of social studies for this. Now this is, like I said, a lot different than other social studies classes. A lot of other social studies classes focus on events and people. We're going to focus more on you and how you work. I guarantee you, though, you get a social studies credit for this, and you will if you're in psych 2 next semester too. So the classroom goals during this core master as I call them, we're going to cover a lot of different topics. Kind of in this one, what I want to do is I want to get through what is psychology and what can you do with it. We're going to do like experimentation and testing in psych. How do psychologists get their information? We're going to talk about the brain and the body and how it affects your behavior and the way you think. We're going to do sensation and perception, motivation and emotion, maybe in this one, maybe we'll do that second semester, and then sleeping and dreaming, if we can get to it, it would be great. And yes, we might, I'm trying to figure out the dream project and how it's going to work like this. So the way that we're going to do this is a lot of different ways. We're going to do some projects. Hopefully, like I said, the dream project is on my radar, and how we need to get started on that and when we need to get started on it. And the answer is actually really, really soon. We're going to do some tests, although they're going to be probably open note, which is going to make them exceedingly more easy than they probably should be. Instead of having you guys have a book, I'm going to give you like weekly short articles with some questions that accompany them. And they're going to be like article guides about the topics that we're talking about. We're going to do some things in breakout rooms, and then we'll have large group discussions. Now, the expectations, what I'm hoping to get out of you behavior-wise, first of all, be respectful to each other and to me. This isn't easy. And so if we're constantly talking over each other or people are arguing, that happened once first quarter, it makes it really hard to get things done. I do understand that sometimes, you know, there's a great opportunity to burn me, toast me, roast me about something I've said or done, and please, by all means, take them. I appreciate get burned as much as anybody, okay? Second thing, make sure you're using proper classroom language. I'm not recording classes. I do these instead, but you know, make sure that you're not swearing, that you're not calling people too many names, things like that, especially not in the chat where there's a lovely written record of it. So be smart about the things that you say. As far as your behavior, remember that you are, to your other classmates, you are a 1-inch by 1-inch square. And my biggest rule from first quarter is don't let your square be a distraction that stops someone else from learning. That wasn't really an issue, but there were a couple of times where it was definitely like, wow, what is going on? Like if you're wearing your Michael Myers mask or whatever. Make sure you're listening to directions. It's okay if I have to repeat myself. It's just really hard like this to tell if people are getting what they need to get. And so if I say like, hey, this is what we're going to do, make sure you're listening to the step-by-step so you know what's going on. On the topic of listening, it gets really distracting if everybody has their microphone unmuted and you just get all the background noise. So it would be really, really appreciated if you would mute your microphone unless you're like actively answering a question or being involved in what's going on in class. I would appreciate that. But at the same time, if you know something and you want to ask a question or you want to talk, unmute your mic and get in there. It's hard sometimes when I ask questions and I sit for 30 seconds hoping someone's going to help me out. Don't misuse the chat. It's not a spot to have a side conversation with someone else. It's not a place to get into an argument. So make sure you're being smart about that. Cameras. I'm going to be really honest. I would love it if you had them on. I would really appreciate it. It makes my job easier. I can see the way you're reacting to things. I can kind of read your face, whether or not you're understanding things. But at the same time, I understand why you would want to have them off. It's just hard on my end if I'm looking at, you know, 28 black squares with little icons in the middle to really get any great interaction out of you. Make sure you're following all the school rules, you know, as they're stated in the handbook. Obviously, you're at home, so there's a lot of leeway with that, but there's obviously some things that can come up that, you know, might not be the best. And make sure you're using your technology appropriately. I do use GoGuardian sometimes, especially when we're working. It allows me to chat with you a little bit more interactively. So, you know, try to be smart about what you're doing. Assignments, you're going to probably have one a week. Make sure it gets handed in on time. I'll probably make them due Thursday or Friday at midnight. And obviously, you guys know I'll take things late up to a week. Proper materials for class. It's going to kind of be up to you what you think you need for class. If you want to keep things in a paper notebook, please, by all means, you know, make sure you have a pen and paper. Just make sure you're keeping track of that stuff and know where it is every day. And last but not least, as far as rules and expectations go, be on the meet on time. It's hard when I have to start, restart, because people are coming and going. So do your best to be on time. It's just it's a respect thing, and I do appreciate it. If you're breaking the rules pretty consistently, I have this nice little ability to eject you out of the meet. And if I do that, you can't get back in for that class day. So you don't want that to happen. And if you're a frequent disruption, then I may have to, you know, take further, you know, things. Grading, there's going to be three standards that we're going to use in this class, and they're very similar to the history classes that you took. We're going to have a content standard, a communication standard, and an analysis and research standard. Each one of those is going to be 1/3 of your grade. So, you know, it's important that you do as well as you can on each one. I try to grade them often, unlike some classes where maybe first quarter your grade was based on two things. I'm going to try to make sure and enter a grade in each one of those things every week. You can use the feedback that I give you about assignments to improve them and improve your grade on things as well. So, you know, remember, it's your grade, you earn it. And so if you have questions about your grade, please ask. Late work, I do take late work, but I will only take it for a week after it's due. So don't be handing something in to me in January that was due here at the beginning of November. I won't take it. Now, as far as the rubrics go, I'm not going to go through each one of them individually because, well, you guys are all really, really good readers. And so I'm sure that you can pop through that and make sense out of things. Okay. Now, some daily information. If you were to miss class, I will record a video like this pretty much every day. The only days I won't are like days where we're just working or something like that. And I will post those by 2 o'clock in classroom. Usually I'm going to try to shoot them before school. But in the event that I can't, I'm going to do them right after classes are over. I'll post them along with any work that may have been done that day, or surveys or tests or forms or anything like that. And you can make them up. Make sure you're making up any work that's missed. Now on this topic, it would be easy, I suppose, to skip class every day and just watch the videos. Problem with that is I know that you're doing the work, but I don't know. So I'm going to have to mark you absent. There's really no way that I'm going to know for sure that you've watched these. If you need help, the last two bullet points have to do with that. I'm going to have daily office hours from 1 to 1:30, just half an hour to start off with. If we need to expand that, I will. That's going to be the same hours for American history and for psychology. And so I never had more than two people first quarter. The link is right there. I'm not going to start that up until after I hand out the first assignment, though. So please, you know, don't hop in there today and expect to see me because I'm not going to be in there. On that tip, if you can't make that 1 to 1:30, you can ask me questions whenever you want to. I am available all the time. Okay, so you can email me, you can chat me, video chat. I'll do my best to get back to you as soon as I can. Other contact information for me is right there. You've got my school email. You've got the school phone number. That is my cell phone number. Probably the biggest reason I give out my cell phone number is because people need it for job references. So just use it. Just let me know so that I know that if I'm getting a call from someplace. If you need to text me for help with homework, I do answer questions via that too. Okay. All right. So that gets some of that stuff out of the way. And so I'm going to go a little bit into me. Why am I here? First of all, the I had a dream thing. I'm not sure. So most of you guys know I grew up in a town just like Marshall, less stoplights actually, and that education was always something that was really important to me. My mom was my school secretary. My dad was on the school board. I always got really, really good grades. When I went to college, I went to Whitewater thinking I was going to be an accountant. And when I decided that was really kind of, honestly for me, seemed boring, and I was trying to weigh my options on what I wanted to do, a lot of that, you know, it came down to I enjoyed school. School was important to me, but also that, you know, I had this really good teacher in high school, and, you know, it was just one of those things that, you know, he kind of influenced me in a direction that I think worked out really, really positively for me in the end. Now, we'll go a little bit more into that tomorrow, but for now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have you guys use the time you have allotted to fill out a survey for me called About You. And if you could do me a favor and fill that out, it just asks some really simple questions about you, interests, things like that. But it also asks questions about how you learn, what makes learning new things hard for you. Also, it goes into why you took this class. So if you have any questions about anything from today, please make sure you look at those rubrics. That's how you're getting graded. Ask questions if you need to. I will see you guys soon. Hope you're well. Bye-bye.